Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Welcome to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight on this Wednesday, August 20th, 2014. I'll be your host today. We have an exciting show coming up. Besides the InfoWars reporters in Ferguson, Missouri that are going to be joining us, we're also going to be joined live in studio by Arthur Thompson. And he's the CEO of the John Birch Society. He's in the area promoting his new book called International Merger by Foreign Entanglements. That's exactly what is happening in the world. They're creating these regional trade zones, just like we saw with NAFTA, like we see with the EU, and now they're creating the Trans-Pacific Partnership, joining these regional trade agreements together. And of course, the people who are controlling this country, people like Petraeus, are saying, you know, what comes after America? Well, that's easy, North America. And he even references the North American Trade Union. So they see this as an accomplished fact. While we're just starting to realize, many of us in the public are starting to see the consequences of the North American Trade Union as we see these open borders, as people like Nancy Pelosi said, we just happen to have this border, these multiple communities that are separated by this border. The border doesn't really mean anything, essentially, is what she was saying. As we see the consequences of this and start to push back against it, many people in the public who have not been following it for decades, like the John Birch Society, they're working on the next stage of this. They're working on taking these regional trading groups and merging them together. So that's the way that they come up with a globalist regime, is through these trade agreements. So I'm very anxious to talk to him about that. We also have news about a geoengineering climate engineering conference that is going on in Berlin as we speak. This week, ending tomorrow, they have a conference on how they can change the climate. Now, we've talked about chemtrails. Alex had a geoengineering special report just last week. We're going to look at a couple of the papers that are going to be presented at this conference, that are being presented, one of them today. A very interesting revelation of what they are up to. We're also going to look more in depth at the Pentagon's 1033 program, the consequences of that. That's the program where they give the equipment to all these local police departments. That's what's fundamentally behind this militarization of the police. And as you're looking at this right now, we've got an article that's up on InfoWars.com. This cop who's running around pointing guns in people's faces. I mean, he's like some kind of a panicked animal. They're just running around with a gun in people's faces. And when they ask him what he's doing, all he says is the F word. You know, I'm going to blow your effing head off. And when they ask him his name, he says, you know, he basically repeats that. Very, very serious to see this kind of thing happening. This kind of unprofessional, provocative behavior. Anybody that's handled a gun knows that you don't point it at somebody you don't plan to shoot. That's a very serious thing, but that's becoming standard operating procedure right now. Where's that coming from? Well, it's being driven by these programs where they give this equipment out to people, get them all hyped up. It's kind of like when you have homeschool, as we were doing that, we were looking at the curriculum. What were we to teach if we're going to pass the test? They can try to drive what you teach in school by setting up the test. They don't have to dictate the curriculum to you directly. They can set it up by setting some standards that you have to get your kids to follow through. That's the same thing they're doing with the police as they train them in this militarized program. One aspect that you probably don't realize is that part of the military surplus program involved giving equipment to firefighters. That was something that went on for several decades before they ever started giving it to the police departments. That went back to right after World War II. They recently tried to shut that down. There was a massive pushback against that. We're going to talk about that. And we have news about the Kardashians. That's right. Right here on InfoWars, we're going to cover some stuff about the Kardashians. They wanted to get into Plum Island, so we're going to talk about that. DARPA's got a new bid out, $150,000, if you can track the spread of chikungunya fever. And also new vaccines on the horizon. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Another major health threat. This one in Toledo, Ohio, where everybody in the entire city has been told not to drink the water.
Ohio's governor declaring a state of emergency.
Did you know that the average person uses about 80 to 100 gallons of water at home every single day? If there's a water emergency, will you be prepared?
Panicked residents forming long lines throughout the day.
We're here at a supermarket in Toledo. You can see the shelves empty where water once was.
To stay safe and healthy during a crisis, you must have access to safe, clean water. Water which will not be available at your local grocery store.
There's a mad dash on right now to stock up on supplies.
The ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system is a must-have for every modern, independently minded household. Protect your family's safety during an emergency. Go to InfoWarsStore.com today to purchase your ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system or call 1-888-253-3139.
I'm David Hall, founder of Diamond Gusset, where we are proud of our 100% grown and sewn American-made jeans. Whether you're out for dinner, working on the farm, or on the road, Diamond Gusset Jeans offers a full spectrum of style and sizes for any occasion. Our loyal customers enable us to continue sponsoring Liberty Media outlets. Use promo code FREEDOM to receive a 15% discount at gusset.com. In Liberty, David Hall, Diamond Gusset Jean Company.
Tell folks how you got introduced to Super Male, and then when Super Female came out, tell us what happened.
After I saw such a huge positive change in my husband, I had to try it for myself.
Talk about the effects.
I feel great when I wake up in the morning. I have drive to go to the gym. I feel like I look better. I feel better. I feel sexier. I love it.
Even if you don't believe in supplements, take the challenge. Get a bottle of Super Male, a bottle of Super Female. Check it out for yourself. Consult your physician. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today. This is life-changing. I began to get into iodine a few years ago because it was helping me and my family so much get healthy and detoxify. Most people know that iodine deficiency has been a crisis around the world. Iodine is key to so many of the body's functions, especially the thyroid. I discovered a product being developed by Dr. Group. You now know it as Survival Shield, true nascent iodine that your body can really absorb. Then, about a year ago, he said, listen, if you think this is powerful, I'm going to come out with rare earth, deep earth crystals. And the results that I personally have had have been life-changing. Nobody else has got iodine based on these pure crystals, ladies and gentlemen. This is innovating, and the best part is it helps fund InfoWars.com, the radio show, the TV show, the whole media operation promoting true libertarian ideas.
For a limited time, experience the ancient power of Survival Shield X2. Take advantage of this unprecedented 30% off Super Detox Special at InfoWarsLife.com.
Now take you live to the Central Texas Command Center in the heart of the resistance.
Welcome to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight on this Wednesday, August 20th, 2014. We're going to be having a conversation with Arthur Thompson, the CEO of the John Birch Society. He's going to be joining us live in studio in the third hour. He's got a new book out, International Merger by Foreign Entanglements. It's exactly, as I pointed out in the last segment, what is happening. They create these regional trade groups, and now as we see the effects 20 years on into NAFTA, they're working on creating the next step, and that is to combine NAFTA, the North American Union, combine that with the European Union, and also combine the North American Union with the Asian trade groups. That's the way they're going to get a globalist control through the corporations, giving them powers that are above what government has. We've also got some breaking news about a geoengineering conference that's going on in Berlin right now. It ends tomorrow. There's going to be a couple of interesting papers we're going to go over there. Of course, Alex Jones had a geoengineering special report last week, and we're going to look at what they're up to. And actually, one of these papers, one of the scientists has a little bit of problem with what they're planning to do, or what we would say they're already doing. You know, that's the sort of thing that you see happening with the surveillance state. For many years, we told you what they were doing. They pretended they weren't doing it right up until the Snowden documents came out. Of course, the head of the NSA was saying, oh, no, we're not spying on anybody. And of course, the senator who asked him a question knew that they were. He had seen the classified documents. He knew he was lying. That's why he was trying to get him to tell the truth under oath, but they don't do that either. So what they do is they do these things. They do it secretly. When you talk about it, they say, you're a conspiracy theorist. You know, these people, Alex Jones, the John Birch Society, all these guys are just into conspiracies. We have an interesting clip that we're going to play you, too, to put things into perspective. Going back to a Larry McDonald appearance on CNN Crossfire with Pat Buchanan and Tom Brayden. You may not know Tom Brayden, but he was someone who was very instrumental in the creation of the CIA. He was someone who created Operation Mockingbird, and he was somebody who had a very large presence in the media. So it was an interesting three-way conversation there between those guys just before Larry McDonald, who was a congressman and also a past president of the John Birch Society. We're going to play some excerpts of that when we talk to Arthur Thompson. We're also going to be going to our InfoWars reporters in Ferguson, Missouri. We're going to look more in depth at this Pentagon 1033 program, which is militarizing our local police departments. You know, that was something else that the John Birch Society for years talked about. Decades ago, they were talking about local control of the police and how important it was that that not turn into federal control. Well, now it's actually moving beyond that. We've got the UN talking about how they want to essentially set up standards for the way the police are going to interact with people. I think they need to be controlled locally. We need to find some method to control the police. Frankly, I think with the federal involvement, they have gone out of control. So we're going to look at that program, and there's something that I don't think many of you have heard about. It's something that was only covered by local stations when it first came out. Back in June, the Pentagon momentarily said that they were going to stop a program of giving military surplus hardware to fire departments. This is a program that had been in effect since the 1950s, shortly after World War II ended, and they started bringing back surplus equipment. They started giving it to fire departments a long time before they started giving it to police departments. They didn't start the police program until the mid-90s. So for 40 years, they were giving surplus equipment to small fire departments, rural fire departments that had to deal with massive wildfires but had a very small population base, could not afford to get this equipment. It was a very useful, very productive thing to do with that equipment. They decided they were going to stop that abruptly at the end of June. There was a major backlash because, you know, firemen don't take things sitting down. They get very active about things. So they got in touch with their congressmen, with their senators. They pushed that back. But for about 3 weeks, people were talking about this program, how it had existed, how necessary and vital it was, how so many of the fires were put out by local people. But the Pentagon wants to militarize the police and do it so quickly that they even wanted to cut this little bit of equipment that they were giving to fire stations. So we're going to talk about that, what's in that program. And we also have Kardashian news. They tried to get onto Plum Island, and they were told, no, sorry, it's kind of secretive here. We're also going to talk about a new DARPA contract, putting an award out, $150,000 for people who can predict how the chikungunya fever is going to move across the United States. They want to track this as they would track a pandemic. Anytime DARPA gets involved in something, you need to watch it carefully. So we're going to talk about the new chikungunya vaccine. It's a new mechanism. It's a very different way that they've got of trying to control the disease. And it also applies to the new Ebola vaccine. So we're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about Plum Island. We're going to talk about some diseases that are put out by tick-borne that tick vector to put this out. So we've got some interesting news on that front. But the top story is what's going on in Ferguson right now. And Alex is going to be joining us in a few minutes to talk about this, because last night, Our reporters got some amazing footage. We have an article up on InfoWars right now about a Ferguson cop who is pointing a gun at journalists and saying, "I'm going to kill you." He's pointing the gun right in their face. And he keeps doing this. And he's just kind of walking around the crowd. If you're watching us, you can see the B-roll there. I don't know how much of this we can play, guys. Can we play some?